I don't do this. This is what I do when I'm chilling. I'm a batting guy. Ask Chris into it. He's not even gonna know that I told you.
I done came up, busted down the hood. Broke, step back. Want you people be swag. Ain't even gotta ask. What are those? What is that? Please don't touch my wrath. Please don't touch my wrath. I'm racked up like rappers. I'm wrapped up on camera. Get out on camera. Squeeze like asthma. It's rare wrath when I wear wrath. Bare wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest into some rap shit. Look, still shit rap. And I'm dripping on rags. We're gonna be the tag. Do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boasting, never brag. Please don't touch my rap. Or the Christian ass. Got a sound of Gucci glasses. W Anderson collab. Yeah, you probably like it. Yeah, you drop it on the. I'ma buy another. Cut the boys, bring it back. Yeah, you know how to make it laugh. Plus, and keep keeping tab. I'ma fly first class. Wait, we'll hit him with it. Please don't touch my rap.
Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Do you know how much I'm spending? My closet, it worth about a million. To the little stuff the runway. Neck, then the kitchen. Ralph Simmons. All kind of crazy colors. Living color.
Left
wrist. Roll it. Ice. Make some Margiela my sweater. Mama told me never settle. Ralph Simmons, don't lace it. Got your one.
Everyone, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today. And there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's Carson Wentz's Eagles going up against Flacco's Ravens.
Larry, we are coming to you from the heart of Baltimore, nestled between Russell Street and I-395. We're at M&T Bank Stadium. Here's a scene a short time ago. The Ravens introduced to this sellout crowd, and through a sea of pyrotechnics, out they came from the tunnel. We're set to go as the Ravens get ready to match up with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Oh, it's four now? You gotta drink another movie. You should. You're paying for me.
It's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. Finding some room at midfield. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They go play action here on first down. Forced out to his left. And now he'll let this one go deep, back over the middle. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
The throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one.
Wentz will try again on second down.
Oh, you cook it.
Heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive. first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. It certainly was a disappointing end of the season for Baltimore as their offense comes back onto the field. But everyone remembers Cincinnati knocking them out of the playoffs on that Andy Dalton to Tyler Boyd play. They finished 9-7. The interesting thing was they had a plus 92 points differential, which was fourth best in the AFC.
So that tells me, and we saw it throughout the season, they were back to playing Baltimore Ravens defense. And that really helped their offense out in a big way. I think they still need help with the skill positions. They've got to upgrade at wide receiver.
There goes Alex Collins. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Alex Collins, 48 yards. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. And the Ravens lead at 7-0. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They'll start out on the ground with a Jay. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. And it's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Now Wentz throwing on second down. That ball's caught. Aguilar right side. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Here's Ajayi. Able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10. This is Ajayi. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, the guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through. And that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. That one good for seven that time. And it'll be first down, Eagles. They'll run it now out of the gun. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there. Second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Torrey Smith, the intended receiver, third down here. Not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Now Wentz on third down. Flush to his right. And some room to work. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Wentz can pull it down when he needs to, and the 6'5 quarterback picks up the first down. From the red zone now, Wentz. Eluding the pressure right. A dump off to Sproles. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 12 yards on back-to-back plays there, and that's another first down. From the gun, it's Wentz. Now he's flushed, and he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. We're back to Baltimore after this. And now the offense gets set for play number 15 on this drive. It has been a long, long stanza for this unit. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It's a loss of two. Now third down. So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Working from the gun, Wentz. And he fires one, but incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Certainly their offense has sputtered here a little bit in the first half as they finally do get on the board, but they only have three.
Well, at least it eases the frustration a bit, doesn't it? Be able to get some points on the board, feel a little bit better about themselves as they go into the locker room and try and regroup.
And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. And when you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
Flacco to throw here on third down. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. Flacco hooking up with Wallace for a Raven first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
They look to throw on first and 10 with Flacco. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They'll get four there out of the screen, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And a nice gain of 21 yards. On first down, Flacco. He's going to air one out. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers. And on that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. And he's got his man. That's Macklin. And he'll go out of bounds down inside the 15-yard line. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down. So they're operating in the red zone. A red zone first down for Flacco. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. Jeremy Macklin, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Once more, it's Flacco. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Third down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. Steps away to his left. Now a hit, and Flacco drops the football. It's loose, and that will get out of bounds. Lucky there. They keep possession inside the five.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession. No turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. To return, here's Michael Campanaro. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turn that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that.
to pass. Flacco got a man. It's Breshad Perriman. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now Flacco throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The veteran Jeremy Maclin was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Throw left side complete. It's Collins. They'll give him a yard on the play, and just like that, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Here's Wentz to throw. Flushed out right. They find some open field here. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. Wentz to throw on second down. Ertz has it left side. 20! And he takes it all the way down to the three. It's a big play there for the Eagles. 46 yards.
Look like you said something else.
Shotgun now for Wentz. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jay Ajayi from 3 yards out. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer
this
time?
Get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Second down following the run. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They go again with Collins. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. Now it's Flacco. Eagle pressure.
share too much this time. Down he goes. Brandon Graham in there to drop him for a loss of 10. And it'll be fourth and long. Here's Sam Cook now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
Throwing on first is Wentz. Looking deep downfield. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Torrey Smith, 59 yards. And the Eagles have taken the lead. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd, and they asked about halftime adjustments and all that was going on. And remember what I said. It's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes just remembering the game plan and playing better, tuning it up and just working through it methodically, they got it done in this case.
Of course, I'll always remember that appearance because I had on a brown belt with black shoes, and you pointed that out in front of the crowd. So thanks for that.
I said that out loud.
You did.
My bad.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Second down now after the pass completion. Operating out of the gun, Flacco. And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. The Ravens on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Now Flacco. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roll free and brings up 4th down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. Got a try it here. He's back to throw. And that's complete. It's Watson. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, big hit. That's good for a Raven first down. 15 yards there. 4th down, trailing in the 4th quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I looked down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need. That's exactly what they got done.
Throwing here on 1st down, Flacco. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Brandon Graham in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon. Second down, Flacco now. And he'll be out of bounds
just shy of the 40. A good pickup there of 22.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And now a first down following that long gain. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game.
Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Brandon Graham able to disrupt yet another pass play. His third sack of the afternoon. Flacco and the Ravens now after the sack need something good here on third and long. Here's Flacco. He hits his target. Left side, Watson. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
And that was a nice catch, and if the goal was to get in the field goal range, it certainly appears that they accomplished that.
Well, sometimes that's what you dial up in these situations, right, when you want 3?
Well, the goal was to get into field goal territory. Even though it'll be a long attempt, I think they accomplished that.
And sometimes you have plays for that. It's not always a first down when you want 3. Get a little bit closer, making an easier shot.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to concede to the defense, and they know what you're trying to get done, and to try and get any more than that is almost folly. Take what you can get, maybe have an opportunity to put 3 points on the board.
Wentz now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
I like his thought process and his ability to move and get downfield. But what I didn't like was the final decision, to go out of bounds. They want to keep the clock moving. Instead, they give the defense an extra timeout.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
As to you said big third down, I'd put the word big in capital letters here. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Whistles now in a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the 2-minute warning. So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock. They'll run it now out of the gun, and he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Now a whistle and a timeout defensively, trying to stop it, and they do with 2 seconds to go prior to the 2-minute warning. Getting late here in the fourth, and if this team has any chance to win this football game, their defense obviously needs a stop here. They'll run it now out of the gun, and they'll stop him right on the midfield stripe. The Eagles on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 4. Now Wentz. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Terrell Suggs. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. I'm surprised with the lead in a 1-score game this late, they're even putting the ball in the air in that situation.
Almost makes me feel like the head coach might be second-guessing himself by not clicking on and saying, all we're doing is running it here. But give credit to the guys on defense. They made a play that they absolutely had to have to give themselves a chance to be in this game.
4 yards remaining now on second down. A give right to Collins. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
They'll look to throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. It'll be a gain of six, and that'll bring up second down.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one. Got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. It may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
He's back to throw. That's into the hands of Wallace over the middle. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Back to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball. Mike Wallace, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And in the second quarter, he may very well run by him. But in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Vinny Curry in there to take him down. And the clock will roll.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Finds his man, Watson, over the middle. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. He'll get 17 back there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. He'll look to throw. First things first here, they got to pick up the first down.
And remember, it is fourth down, so they've got to pick up a completion here. Otherwise, this one's over.
8 yards on the pickup, and the Ravens are going to have a first down. Pressure mounting, Flacco. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock. And now time for one final play that has to be obviously in the end zone.
Can't wait to see what they call, but you want to get it to your best player. Sometimes you have to do it by formation. Move everyone to one side, and maybe he gets a one-on-one isolated on the back.
And it's caught. It's a touchdown with zeros on the clock, and an extra point will send us to OT.
Well, there's no doubt they just seized the momentum with that one. They can go ahead and kick the extra point here and ride that home wave on into overtime.
Now for the all-critical extra point. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple.
I'll be right back. All right. This nigga start the game. I only got 30 seconds. I'm watching the 5 minutes. Stop. Push the middle button. Call him up. The big middle button, nigga.
Here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT.
Ha 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 ha!
Here's a handoff to Ajayi to begin the drive. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Drops it off to Ajayi. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Room to run past midfield. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, we got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
They find Aguilar over the middle, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you got a lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. Hoping to keep this OT drive alive. Now they face a 3rd and 2. The tight end changing his position. They run again with Ajayi. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Okay.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
Time running out here on the play clock. Wentz now on first down. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, and it's second down. Another nice job there defensively. They've really stymied their passing attempts, and it continues in overtime.
And for them to do that, that means they've had to be cohesive on defense. Pressure in the quarterback's face, good coverage of not just the wide receivers, but the tight end, the running backs when they try and slip out, and making sure they're at the point of attack. When the ball's in the air, they get there and help force some of those incompletions.
All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front, because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Now wins. And this is caught.
It's a lot of bad things that they wish, and they wish, and they wish, and they wish. Ooh, I fucking won. In your face. There you go. She said that you love me. I tell her only part of me. I don't even know my head and my mind.
Styles on them like it's common sense. Hopped out the Benz like it's common sense. Put a monkey on my feet like it's common sense. Got gorillas in the streets like it's common sense. Stack the money heads up like it's second nature. Gotta stay pulled up like it's second nature. Keep a chip in my hair like it's second nature. Big make me care like second nature. Zeds disappear like second nature. On the same block like an hour later. Whole team eating, but it's only right. There's a spare plate, but you're the phony type. J-Hus ugly in it. Baby, 1 minute. You're looking wicked. Hey, yo, I started off.